So I started out wanting to tell a story about the remarkable work of adaptive ski programs that help people with disabilities get on skis. I learned about a fundraiser for one such program and thought that would be a great short video. Get footage of different kind of people with different kinds of abilities, mix in background interviews, add a soundtrack. How hard can that be? In the end, I found even more interesting stories to tell. One story about the bond forged between people with different abilities, like my daughter Margot, and all those who teach them, including the volunteers who drive the amazing work of adaptive ski programs. And an even more fascinating story about how this bond grows even stronger through the magic of skiing together when you reach a state of synchro. Margot and I began our own story by hiking, biking, and kayaking together. It was not easy, but it has been really important for both of us. As a researcher, I learned that people with disabilities have few activities that get them out of the house and that offer exercise. As a psychologist, I learned that an unexciting and unhealthy life can make other behavior problems a lot worse. And as Margot's dad, I just wanted us to have fun together. And so we ended up at Tutop Mountain Adaptive Sports Foundation, getting Margot her first ski lessons.
She's going too fast. Okay. That was amazing.
Look at you.
Wow.
At Tutop, I began to learn the wonderful story of adaptive outdoor recreation programs and came to appreciate the dedication required to make them successful. And a year later, I ended up filming their 100K challenge, in which teams of skiers raise money from sponsors by committing to complete 100,000 vertical feet in ski runs in one day.
Hey, welcome everybody. Thank you so much. Our fundraiser is climbing. We really took a jump yesterday, and we're approaching 45,000. We're thrilled with that.
145
will be cool too.
These programs provide thousands of lessons each year on a shoestring, relying on grants, annual giving, the generosity of ski resorts, and fundraisers like the 100K challenge.
So this fundraiser is essential in allowing us to continue to purchase lift tickets for the family members when they come with our wounded warriors. So again, thank you so much for your help.
Adaptive outdoor recreation programs are truly special. By skiing, biking, kayaking, and so on, they connect differently abled people to the outdoors and get them to push their bodies and their limits. But perhaps most remarkable about each of these programs is how they can rely almost exclusively on an army of volunteers who share the vision of a founder.
All right, let's see, let's do a yee on three. 1, 2, 3.
Yee!
Give me a haul. 1, 2, 3.
Haul!
Anyone who has tried to build a program that depends almost entirely on volunteers knows just how hard that can be.
Glove!
I put it there for a reason. Not lost.
Of course.
But 2 minutes at Tutop, and you can tell that these volunteers are so committed to this work and so connected to the people they want to help.
How many outfits today?
Like 5-ish?
Nice.
Maybe more.
T-Rex counts as one.
How do you build an army this committed and this connected?
I want to get a time lapse of every outfit.
Oh, yeah.
That's the goal.
It's not a skirt, it's a kilt.
Is that number two?
This is going to be four?
When you're wearing the flag like that, are you allowed to pass gas? Or is that, like, illegal?
It's illegal to wear this, isn't it?
Perhaps this grows from greater awareness and understanding of people with different abilities.
Are you skiing with me, Peter? All right.
You just see what you'd like to do, and I will catch up if I can. All right.
Maybe now, more people know someone who needed a hand to get back on their feet, like Dan, or to just get on their feet for the first time, like Margot.
I mean, I skied before I had lost my leg, so I had a little bit of, you know, advantage, but it was kind of, it was like, all the concepts are there, and,
yeah.
And there's a lot of adapted programs to ski.
And so maybe these volunteers are so committed because they know someone who needed help, or because they are inspired by the determination, resilience, and the grace of these people whose luck failed them when God rolled the dice.
You know, you feel like you're just, hey, you're just part, you're just on the mountain. Everyone's always like, hey, man, nice work. But you just feel like you're out there skiing, man.
Yeah.
And it's pretty cool. But yeah, definitely got my confidence back up. Yeah, it was just awesome to get that sense of speed back.
I can't keep up with him.
Maybe there are more people committed to volunteering because we now understand that these programs also help many more whose challenges are not so visible, who are trying to heal from trauma, violence, addiction, or depression. This includes the many wounded warriors that Two Top has made special efforts to reach.
One of the things that I got involved with last year was the Navy team trials for the Warrior Games, and the amount of courage and confidence and teamwork, and I've been in the Navy 18 years, and I've never seen anything like that.
Volunteering itself offers those helped a chance to help others.
My wife says, you know, in the last year, because of all these different warrior programs that I'm involved with, that I'm not the same person.
Yeah.
And she feels like she got her husband back.
But this commitment and connection reminds me of something else. The kind of magical bond that I have seen grow between differently abled people like Margot and all those who have helped them to achieve a breakthrough by working together. You often have to work so closely with differently abled people to understand their strengths and their struggles that you not only see the next smallest step, you experience their struggle to take it. So you feel like you are taking it together, and you share in the joy that results.
Yay! Look at you! You're doing it! You're doing it! You're doing it! You're doing it! Look at you!
Watching the work of volunteer instructors like those at Two Top and elsewhere, and learning to ski with Margot myself, I see a bond forged here that is even stronger because of the particular combination of speed, precision, risk, and thrill achieved when you have to ski so closely together. I call this particular combination achieving a state of synchro. This is like the state of flow that Mihai Csikszentmihalyi described in musicians, mountain climbers, and others who experience profound joy and self-transcendence at the moment they lose themselves in a complex and creative task. A state of synchro is also like the sport of synchro skiing, when you ski in close formation at the very edge of your abilities, experiencing flow together. Perhaps the technical precision required to teach someone like Margot is different, but the experience can be equally exhilarating. You must physically guide your student, scan the terrain ahead for people and pitches to avoid, determine when and how to turn, monitor how they might be thinking and feeling, and at the moment when you have brought them to the edge of their abilities, you decide whether to risk the next step to reach for next breakthrough. You lose yourself in this magical moment. You don't just move and think as one, you feel the risk and the thrill of skiing as one. And the moment when you make that next breakthrough together, there is no disability, there is no trauma, nothing seems out of reach. This moment, the state of synchro, is so priceless and so profound.
Hey!
Hey, caught up with you.
Ah, here we go. Maybe we should just do synchro.
Okay.
Do synchro.
Same again.
Yeah.
How priceless. How profound. No one expressed this better than Tom, a former Air Force pilot who has helped countless differently abled people get on skis over the years, including Margot.
A wounded warrior with two trips, two tours in Iraq, came to see us. He had skied for many years. It had been many years since he was in Iraq. He had acute PTSD. He had been a skier, and he hadn't skied for quite a while. I believe he was in his mid-40s. And as we were riding the beginner chair for our first trip down the beginner's slope, I asked him what he would like to accomplish today. And he said, I would like to overcome my fear. And I said, well, if you'd been that good of a skier, we'll probably have that fear taken care of before the morning lesson is over. And he said, no, I'm afraid of everything. Wow. I knew that I had my work cut out for me after that. He came every week for 5 weeks, and after the fifth week, he came up to me. Tears were streaming down his face. He put his arms around me, and he hugged me. And he said, Tom, you'll never know what you've done for me. And when he was done hugging me, and when the hug ended, I had tears in my eyes. Oh, wow.
And so that is how you recruit an all-volunteer army dedicated to helping differently abled people discover skiing, rewarded by the profound joy of achieving this breakthrough together in a state of synchro.
We're just waiting for somebody with a number to come down.
So we can declare victory?
Yes.
Victory.
Okay.
It's a wrap.
Yep.
You want this?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Awesome. Thank you.